Okay, you're looking at Lemmy Kilmister's prototype Minaret Guitars signature model bass. Recording studio just last year. That was 6 months before he passed away, that picture you're looking at. And he did a whole bunch of publicity photos for us, and he really believed in this instrument.
Winter NAMM 2016 at the Minaret Guitars booth with the one and only Mark Minaret. Mark, how are you?
Good to see you again, Lewis. Everything's great, man. We're having a good time at NAMM. It's great. 2016's turning out to be a good year for us.
I always love stopping by your booth, seeing, I mean, some of there's nobody that does what you do, right?
No, we've got the market cornered on Unusual, and we try to bring something.
I call it exotic.
Exotic, sure. We try to bring something heavy every year and to keep people guessing where we're going to go next. So this year is no exception. We've got some stuff to bring it to the community and keep people, you know, juiced on creating new music and getting guitar-based music back into the push of what's popular and on the radio everywhere, as opposed to a lot of electronica that's going on right now. Yeah. So we're always pushing to drive it towards guitar-based music and be part of that pendulum swing back in that direction.
That's awesome.
Thank you.
So before we got the camera rolling, you had shared with me a story about Lemmy and the Medusa bass.
Sure.
Can you share that story with me and the folks tuning in?
Sure. I haven't really told anyone this story yet, so this will be the first time.
Can I hold the bass while you tell the story?
Yeah, let me grab that and put it in your hand. Got it. Okay, you're looking at Lemmy Kilmister's prototype Minaret Guitars signature model bass. They invited me down to the studio where they were recording, and which ended up being their last album. They just finished it last year. Invited us to the studio. We brought the bass down. We've got video of him jamming this bass during the recording of the album. He loved the bass. We were all ready to go, and everybody was surprised that, you know, he passed away. You know, it was a real, real unpleasant surprise for everybody. But we've been working with him on this bass for probably a year and a half to 2 years, getting the design just right, doing it just the way he wanted. And again, I don't have it on me, but he had us film him playing this in the studio while they were recording.
But you have the picture.
Oh, of course. The picture on the wall there, that's in the recording studio just last year. That was 6 months before he passed away, that picture you're looking at. And he did a whole bunch of publicity photos for us, and he really believed in this instrument. So we're going to work with the estate and their management and try to get this out to the public, because it was something Lemmy believed in, and we of course were excited to have him on board playing something like this, considering, you know, he's such a legend. So nobody really knows really we were developing this with him, and that, you know, he actually played on it, got it in his hands, approved it. So it was a real pleasure that you asked me about this, because I really haven't had an opportunity to tell anyone that we've kind of had this under wraps trying to get it ready to launch. So you're looking at it here for the first time anywhere in the world, Lemmy's signature Minaret bass. And this is something we look forward to showing you, that video of him playing it and really getting into it and being happy with the finished product there.
If I may, can you hang on to that for a sec?
Sure.
So your dad had shared something with me, which I thought was interesting. Where's the picture of that in here? Oh, here it is. It was like one of those, you know, real cool wow moments. Hang on. There it is. So Mark's dad, who I'm a dear friend, had said when he took the picture, you know, it wasn't done yet. Like you had said, you were working on this for a while. And they said they never cut the truss rod out yet, and he said if you look at the truss, the headstock, they left it as is, you know, where they left off, they just left it as is, you know, just kind of a tribute. So this really is a one of a kind, this one right here.
I mean, yeah, I know we've had hundreds of people at the show wanting to buy this bass. And we've only been here a day and a half. Hundreds of people wanting to get this. it's kind of a tough emotional thing for me. I don't know if that's going to happen, but I won't lie. The interest has been pretty overwhelming, and some of the numbers I've had thrown at me were pretty outrageous.
Yeah.
But just as far as something that's historical for, you know, fans of Motorhead, I mean, guys, he was in on this from day one. This is the bass he wanted to play.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I don't know what else I can tell you. You know, if you like Lemmy and you like his sound and style, he was in on the pickup selection, the build and everything, and he was absolutely ecstatic when he jammed it recording this album. He had us film that so people would know that this was something he was really liking and he was a part of. So we have the footage, and we just want to make sure we do it right, and we, you know, give respect to the management and the estate. But showing it here at the NAMM show was fine. Everybody was really happy to have that happen, so it's a real honor to be able to let people see this for the first time.
There it is, Minerick Guitars with Mark Minerick, the Lemmy bass, Winter NAMM 2016. Later.